So over the years of doing this, I've been evolving my mouse cam. It started just being on top of a monitor, then I finally got it on a stand. And now I have it right above the pad, which is a blue screen, so you only see the mouse in the footage. But the stand doesn't look too good, and it's a bit awkward. I then reviewed the Elgato key lights and said they needed better arms and attachments. Turns out they did have them, so they sent some out for me, and they have a thread on them to use with the webcams. I also wanted to mount it to my desk instead of having a big platform. This light here is fine, because I can slide the base under the case, but this other one is just kind of in the way, so I'm going to change both of these over. Now in the flex arm kit, you get four attachments. Pretty simple, just open up and put the ball in, so you get almost full movement with them, and you can adjust the way you like. And in the multi-mount kit, you get the base that clamps onto the desk, and you can extend them up to 1.25 meters. The minimum height is 55 centimeters, so pretty high. And this is what I've set up for the mouse cam. It is a fairly expensive kit, but it's sturdy and feels high quality. Like both of the sides that clamp onto the desk are padded, which means they won't damage your desk. And it actually gives me much more flexibility with where I position the camera and how. So then combined with the blue screen mouse pad and it's right out of my vision. I can play with the mouse on screen, no problems. As for the light, just putting it on the side of the desk and then using the flex arm kit, I can now have it right above the mouse. Again, it just clamps onto the desk. It's nice and sturdy and I can move it around how I want. I can even just put it out of the way when I'm done. And so when I film the products for review, this is what it can now look like. So this is not for everyone and most gamers are not going to need them, but for streamers and content creators, especially ones that have made it their full-time job, I think they're a worthwhile investment. In fact, I actually want a few more of these so I can put even more lights up. And because I do a lot of video work, I actually look for these sorts of products. And thankfully, Elgato is actually one of the few companies catering to our needs. So anyway, that's how I'm doing my mouse cam and lighting. And for those interested, the Razer Kayo has been the best because it has that extra light on it. Even with extra lighting around, the webcam seemed to need that extra boost. Now, Corsair also sent me these LT100 light towers. Here's what you get in the box. They're pretty simple, just put the tower poles into the bases, plug them into each other with the 1.5 meter cable included, plug them into the power, and then into the PC. Although a note here, that's three extra cables you're going to run on your desk. And honestly, these just seem like a trial product, as in Corsair is testing the waters. For example, I'm trying to film these in rainbow mode, and they're so bright I can't even match it up with the other lights. But they're not bright enough to really light up a wall either. I hope Corsair put in an option to change the brightness in the software, because right now I can't really make use of these. They look cool, but they're not that cool. I was really hoping they'd come out with some sort of spotlight, so when you face it against the wall, you can actually theme your setup. These just seem like the light bars, but vertical, but not as good. And it's just extra clutter, extra cabling. Sorry to say, but I don't think these are worth it. I have been using the LS100 strips. They've been great, so I can recommend those. But the light towers, well, if you can find the use, good, but I can't, so I think these need some work. The one feature I like is that you can have a headset holder on them. And in case it wasn't obvious, Corsair did send this all out to me, but the video is not sponsored or biased, all thoughts are my own. But I do appreciate it, so big thanks to Corsair for that, and I'm still looking forward to RGBing everything in the future. Usual links below if you want to help support what I do, and subscribe, like and share this video, and I'll catch you in the next.